Okay, in this one we're going to talk about the parallel keyword, which allows you to, well, run jobs in parallel. So here you can see I have a repo with a very basic CI/CD that just runs the unit test. And what we're going to do is a thing that you want to do often when you do unit testing or formatting or any form of test or deployment is you want to run those for multiple distribution or multiple versions of the programming language you're using or the libraries you're using. So in our case, Python, we would like to test our application on both Alpine Linux, but also Debian. And we also want to test all the versions of Python that we support, like 3.9, 3.10, and so on and so on. And a very good, this is a very good use case for the parallel keyword. So let's go back in our CI/CD file. Let's remove the basic one and copy paste the example I've cooked up. So this is the same job essentially, like it still runs PyTest. But here you can see we have a parallel keyword, and it has in itself a matrix keyword. And here you can specify for each of the jobs that are gonna run in parallel different environment variables. So in this case, it's going to run through, it's going to have a Python version environment variable and an OS variable, which is going to be either Alpine or Bullseye. Bullseye is just a version of Debian. And here we're going to have three different versions of Python. And what's going to happen is it's going to generate six jobs. So you can imagine it's going to run Alpine, then three versions of Python. And then it's gonna run Bullseye with three versions of Python. And so here I just print the OS in the Python version. And yeah, I should mention that in the image, of course, I use Python and then I use the environment variables here. And that's how you switch Docker image for each of those jobs. And so it's just gonna run those six unit tests on different OSs and on different Python versions. Let's see how it looks. So yeah, here we can see that I committed and pushed my code, and we can see that all the six jobs were all launched in parallel. And each of those is gonna have different OS and a different Python version. And you can see that already some of them are done. And here, this is the 3.11 Alpine. So you can see that the Docker image they use was Python 3.11 and Alpine Linux. One other use case for this, they show in the documentation, is when you have different providers. So here they have AWS, OVH, and then you can deploy your application to all of those in parallel with just simple environment variables. Another use case I could think about is if you have like a test syst prod environment, you can, or at least maybe, or like multiple test environment or different regions. Stuff like that, you could deploy to those in parallel. And yeah, that's most of the use case I see for parallel matrix. And then a use case I discovered with this video of parallel is that you can just have a number for parallel, which will just launch the same job 5 times. And the only difference between those jobs is that they will have a CI node index and a CI node total. CI node total will just be the number of jobs that will run in parallel, and the CI node index will just be the index of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And yeah, I've never used this, but I can see how it would be useful if you have some kind of computation you have to do and you want to just run it in parallel, but in a very easy way. Or if you have like multiple queries to do, which can be easily indexed. So, but yeah, to just showcase what it would look like, let me just quickly run through an example. So here I just have again this test job, but that has an echo for the node index and the node total, and I have parallel with five jobs. Let's see how this looks. So yeah, here you can see that it launched indeed five jobs, and well, they're all done because it was a pretty easy task. But you can see here, for example, I'm in 2 out of 5, and it says job 2 out of 5. So those environment variables are different amongst the jobs. And so yeah, that's about everything there is to know about parallel. And yeah. See you in the next one.